Good morning, students. In today's lecture, we will talk about the solubility of gas in a given solvent or in water. The solubility of any gas in solvent or water is decided by the three factors. Factor number one, nature of gas and nature of the solvent. Factor number two, temperature. And factor number three, the most important factor, that is pressure. So let us talk about factor first, that is nature of gas and nature of solvent. It is seen that the gases which are easily liquefiable or gases which can be converted to liquids easily are more soluble in water if compared with the gases which cannot be converted to liquids easily. So easily liquefiable gases are more soluble than the gases which are not easily liquefiable, or the gases which can react with water and form ions are also more soluble than the gases which are not reacting with the water and forming ions. Like, let us talk about carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide reacts with water H2O to form H2CO3, which is called carbonic acid. Carbonic acid undergoes ionization, as a result of which we obtain H+ and CO3 minus 2 ion, that is carbonate ion. We can also take an example of NH3 ammonia. NH3 reacts with H2O water and form ammonium hydroxide, that is NH4OH. Ammonium hydroxide, being a basic compound, forms NH4+ and OH minus ion, ammonium ion and hydroxide ion. So carbon dioxide and ammonia are more soluble than dihydrogen or hydrogen gas, or dioxygen or oxygen gas, because H2 and O2 does not react with water. And because these are not reacting with water, their solubility is always lower than the solubility of carbon dioxide and the solubility of ammonia. So this is factor number one. Now, factor number second, temperature. It has been observed that if the pressure is kept constant and temperature is increased, then the solubility of gas in water or the solubility of gas in any solvent decreases. It means if the temperature is increased, then the solubility of gas will decrease, because dissolution of gas in water or in any solvent is an exothermic process. Whenever gases dissolve in water or whenever gases dissolve in solvent, heat energy is released. So it can be explained with the help of Lee-Chatelier principle. For the exothermic process, low temperature is favorable, and here the process is exothermic. That's why low temperature will be favorable, or we can say if temperature is increased, solubility of gas in water or solubility of gas in solvent will decrease. Now, let us come to the third point or the third factor, which is the most important factor, that is effect of pressure on solubility of gas. The quantitative relationship between solubility of gas with the pressure was first explained by scientist Henry. And from there, we have got Henry's law. So effect of pressure on solubility of gas is also called Henry's law. In soft drinks, in cold drinks, carbon dioxide is dissolved in water at a very high pressure. When we open the bottle of thumbs up or any cold drink, what happens? We observe formation of bubbles. Why we are getting bubbles? Because when we are opening the bottle, we are decreasing the pressure. So the gas which is dissolved in water at high pressure now becomes insoluble and will be escaped to surroundings, or we can say atmosphere. So according to Henry's, solubility of any gas in solvent or in water is directly proportional to pressure applied. So here, if we assume a container which is having water or any solvent, and here is the gas. So if pressure is increased over the gas, where the gas molecules will go? The gas molecule will go inside the water or inside the solvent. And if gas molecules are going inside the water, inside the solvent, it means the gas is soluble. So solubility of any gas in any solvent or water is directly proportional to pressure applied. So we can say that pressure applied over the gas is directly proportional to mole fraction of the gas in the solvent or in the water. This X is the mole fraction of gas in solvent or in the water, and here it represents solubility of the gas. Removing this sign of proportionality, we will having a constant KH. So P can be written as P equals to KH into H, where KH is called Henry's constant. And this mathematical expression is called Henry's law, where we have developed quantitative relationship between pressure applied and solubility of gas. X, the mole fraction, here represents solubility of gas in water or in any solvent. Now, about KH, Henry's constant, its unit. Because X is a pure number, so the unit of Henry's constant will always be equals to unit of pressure. If here we are using atmosphere as a unit of pressure, then unit of KH will be atmosphere. If we are using another unit of pressure, that is bar, then the unit of KH will be bar. The value of KH is different for different types of gases. And value of KH increases as we increase the temperature. That's why the solubility of gas will decrease. Suppose a gas is dissolved at a particular pressure and we are increasing the temperature. With the increasing temperature, the value of KH will increase. What we want? We want left hand side should be equal to right hand side. So if this value is increased, then automatically this value will decrease. So if temperature increased, value of KH increases, as a result of which value of X decreases, or we can say solubility of gas decreases. That's why aquatic species are more comfortable in water during winter season in comparison to summer season. What's the reason? The pressure on the water body is same everywhere, that is atmospheric pressure, we can say 180 m or 760 mm/g. Now in summer season the temperature is more, so value of KH will be more. So what happens? The value of dissolved oxygen in water will decrease. So definitely there will be less oxygen available in the form of dissolved oxygen in water in summer season in comparison to winter season. Or we can say in summer season there is scarcity of oxygen in the water bodies due to increase in value of KH as temperature is more during summer season. So what is Henry's law? Henry's law is P equals to KH into S, and it explains the quantitative relationship between the pressure applied and the solubility of the gas in solvent or in water. The last point that is important. Suppose we are having mixture of gases here, like O2 is there, N2 is there, H2 is there. Then due to all gases we will be having total pressure. In that condition the partial pressure applied by the nitrogen gas will decide the solubility of nitrogen in water, not the total pressure. The partial pressure applied by the oxygen will decide the solubility of oxygen in water, not the total pressure applied due to presence of nitrogen, oxygen and hydrogen. So whenever mixture of gases are there, then the value of partial pressure decides the solubility of the gas. It's all over. And solubility of gases in water or solvent. Thank you and have a nice day.